What's up, everybody? It's me, Troy, and I'm back again with another drawing video. So anyway, this particular drawing has been sitting somewhere on my shelf for like, I don't know, over a month, and I decided, you know what the hell, I'm tired of trying to figure out exactly what I'm going to do with this drawing. So I decided to just, you know what, jump into the game and just go ahead and put it all together. So I appreciate you for stopping by, and we'll get started. First, I'm inking him right away. I'm using my favorite ink pen, which is a Precision V5 Extra Fine Pen, one in which you can find at any Walmart or sporting goods shop, which is actually not true about the sporting goods part. Anyway, we're going to move this right along, and here I am inking away. You know, I was really kind of mad because this ink pen was kind of smudging up the picture just a touch. I wasn't giving it time to dry, basically. So, as always, I'm going to color in the eyes. I decided to make him have green eyes, so I just used your standard green marker to outline his eyes. And then I'm going to use a 1.0mm ink pen to do his bushiness in these brows. I want to give him some bushy eyebrows, and I think I kind of successfully made that so. And then I'm using, of course, that same V5 Precision pen to fill in his top eyelid and bottom eyelid. And I love making the eyelids like super scratchy looking, which is so old school manga style. Not saying I'm a manga artist, but I'm very much inspired by a lot of manga artists from the 90s. And then next, I'm going to use a standard brown marker pen to fill in the areas of his hair, which is going to be brown. And this pen was giving me some problems because it was extra dry. And then I use my Copic pen, which I'm using a flesh tone, and I'm just going to outline his lip. So you know what, I'm just going to shut up and just go ahead and show what's going on in the picture, in the video. Excuse me. Oh yeah, and I got to take a picture for the blog. So next, here I am erasing all of the remaining sketch marks. And because I was experiencing some smudginess, I used a black eraser also to try to get some of the ink out of the way that smudged. I just, you know, damn it, if I would have waited for the ink to dry, I would have been good to go. But I was so tired of looking at this drawing. I feel like breaking out into a Brandy song right now with this mic in front of me. Baby, 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 yeah. Erasing away. Erase and dust. I used this fine eraser pen actually to get some of those finer close quarter lines, like the bridge of his nose and his eyelids and that sort of thing, because I wanted to be extra careful in case those areas smudge, because you know that's gonna be a problem. Oh yeah, and then I got my three shades of green. I love giving the eyes a gradient effect, so starting from the pupil outwards, I make it dark and make it as light as I can go going out. So his eyes look like the field of grass, rolling hills tumbling towards the earth. Something out of a Toni Morrison book, I think. Well, the rolling hills part is, but you know, the rest isn't. Now I'm using a water pastel. Okay, now I need to edit this right. Now I'm using a watercolor to just give him a base foundation color, you know, on his hair. Gosh, I'm mixing my words up. I'm using a watercolor to color in the brownness of his hair. And it'll be the first top coat layer. Just spread it right in there. It's really hard to do because, well, I won't say hard, but you have to just kind of be patient with it because, hell, his hair is so short, I could mess up the whole entire picture if I don't be careful. Which I kind of experienced some heaviness on one side of his face when I was coloring in the watercolor. But you can always soak it up if you can with a dry brush. So yeah, I'm gonna fan him and see if I can get him to dry even faster. And then I'm going back with that Copic pen and filling in all of the areas of shade and shadow. I'm not a shade and shadow expert. I don't know if anybody is, but hell, I just go with a guesstimation of where each shade and shadow should be. I like that shade and shadow. But of course, that would be the horn of his ear and his eyelids and the bridge of his nose. And I love, absolutely love coloring in the top part of the lip. Some people wonder why I only color the top part of the lip on male characters, but it's just because I love it. Like, I just can't make a line for lips normally. I have to give it some kind of definition and color. You know, with the female characters, you can always make it lipstick and draw a full lip or color a full lip, but not with male characters unless they're transvestite, which I'm okay with drawing too. I think I've done that before. And I don't use Copic pencils to color in large spaces, so if you haven't seen my drawings before, you'll see what else I use instead later on. Another picture for the blog, of course. And now I'm going to use an X-Acto knife to get him out of that negative space, and we're going to give him some color in his background. Give him some color in his life. Okay, I think I'm gonna go ahead and see you in part 2.